In this video, we will create a simple Memcached Ansible operator using the Operator SDK, which is a part of the operator framework. But before we start typing away at the terminal, let's quickly review how an operator works. An operator is a Kubernetes controller that deploys and manages applications, resources, and services in Kubernetes. In Kubernetes, each of your application's resources can be defined by a custom resource definition, or CRDs. CRDs uniquely identifies your application's custom resources by its group, version, and kind in a Kubernetes cluster. Once the CRDs have been created, you would then create an instance of the custom resource, or CR, with a unique name. The Operator SDK provides an option to create an Ansible operator. An Ansible operator leverages the full power of Ansible, and it does not require the knowledge or the experience of any other programming language. You just write some Ansible and edit a few YAML files to get your operator up and running. The Ansible operator uses the watches file to know what resources the operator should watch, and it also tells the operator what to do when the resource gets created or when it changes. As you can see in this slide, the CRD file defines a resource kind called memcached in the group cached.example.com and version v1-alpha-1. Then we use the CR file to create an instance of our custom resource named example. And the watches file will monitor the memcached CR and run an Ansible role called memcached. Now that we have some background, let's go to the terminal and create our memcached Ansible operator from scratch. Before we begin, you'll need to have access to a Kubernetes cluster. In this demo, we'll be using a Minikube cluster. Then you'll also need to have Operator SDK and Ansible installed. We'll use the --type equals Ansible option to create a new project for our memcached Ansible operator. As you can see, this will create the following files. The deploy directory contains the files that we need to deploy our memcached Ansible operator. As mentioned earlier, CRD contains our application resource definition for memcached, and we will use the CR file later to actually instantiate a custom resource named example. The RBAC file defines the access control for our operator. Details on how the RBAC is used is out of scope for this video. If you have any questions regarding the role-based access control, please review the RBAC link in the reference section for further information. And as you can see, the watches file show that our operator will be watching the resource memcached and will run the Ansible role memcached when the resource is created or changed. The roles directory contains the file for our Ansible role memcached. The temp folder contains the Docker file, which we'll use later to containerize our operator. Now that we have created the directory structure, let's make some edits. First, let's define what our memcached role would do when a user creates a custom resource for the memcached. So we'll open up the main task file, and we'll create a Kubernetes deployment for memcached like so. Please note that this Ansible task is creating a Kubernetes deployment using the Kates Ansible module. The Kates Ansible module allows you to easily interact with Kubernetes resources idempotently. Please also note the replica size section of the deployment. It's using the variable size to define the replica size of pods for the memcached deployment. We're making this a variable so that the end user interacting with the custom resource can declare the value of the size they want, then that value will make its way from the CR to the Ansible code. Since we don't have a default set for the size variable yet, let's do so right now by setting the default value to 1. Now that we've made our edits, we can go ahead and build our operator into a container image. As you can see, the container image will have our Ansible roles and our watches file. We'll build our image with the Operator SDK build command like so. And we'll push the image to a registry. Okay, to run our memcached Ansible operator, we'll first define our custom resource with the CRD file by issuing the kubectl create command on our CRD file. Next, we'll create an access control for our operator with the RBAC file. Now, let's take a look at our operator.yaml file. This file contains a Kubernetes deployment for our operator. We'll replace the replace image with the image that we've built and pushed earlier. Now before running the operator, I will open another terminal window and do a kubectl get all so we can watch what's happening in the cluster as we run the operator. I will also open another terminal and see what's going on in our operator pod. And to run our operator, I will once again issue the kubectl create on the operator YAML file. And as you can see, the operator pod was created and it's pulling the image and the pod is running and ready to go. Now, we will create a memcached custom resource. This creates an example-memcached deployment with one pod. As you can see, a new pod called example-memcached is created and is now running. Our operator is watching our custom resource and keeping the deployment as we've declared it in our memcached role. Now, we can update the declare state to say we want to see more instances in the memcached. We do this by modifying the size in the CR. The operator will detect the CR has changed and it will invoke Ansible to new desired state. Then Ansible will be in charge of ensuring the world matches what is declared in the CR. So to change the size in the CR, we'll simply edit the CR file and apply changes using kubectl apply command. We'll open the CR file and we'll add spec section to it and we'll define the size variable to be 3. Then we'll run the kubectl apply on the file. As you can see, two new pods were created. We can also change the size again, this time down to 2 pods. And kubectl apply those changes. And as you can see, one pod gets terminated. Please review the comment section for more resources and links, and thank you very much.